इत्यादि की।
सर सोलो सर
चेक 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 टेस्ट वन टू चेक चेक
सेट
हाँ जी
अमित जी सबसे पहले तो जानना चाहेंगे कि ये जो कह सकते हैं कि जो आपने आपकी तरफ से जो सपोर्ट है स्टोरी टेलिंग का हम देखते हैं हमारी इंडस्ट्री में लोग इस तरह से सामने नहीं आते और उनका सपोर्ट नहीं मिलता स्टोरी टेलिंग आप आए हैं तो आप
दरअसल अंजुम का जब मुझे फ़ोन आया कि सिनेस्तार ये करना चाह रहा है एक स्क्रीन राइटिंग कॉम्पिटिशन रखना चाह रहे हैं तो मुझे बड़ी खुशी हुई क्योंकि हिंदुस्तान इतना बड़ा देश है और यकीनन बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिनके मन में कहानियां हैं जो कहना चाहते हैं मौका नहीं मिलता तो ये एक अच्छा तरीका है जिसमें कि देश भर से लोग अप्लाई कर सकते हैं अपनी अपनी कहानियाँ भेज सकते हैं और मुझे लगता है कि फ़िल्म इंडस्ट्री को भी इसकी सख्त ज़रूरत है हमें फ़्रेश राइटर्स चाहिए अलग अलग ख्याल चाहिए लोगों के तो आई थिंक जूही मुझे और राजू जी को जब इनवाइट किया अंजुम जी ने तो हम तीनों को भी ये लगा कि ये एक बहुत अच्छा अटेम्प्ट है और हमें इसे सपोर्ट करना चाहिए इसलिए हम लोग तीनों आगे आए हैं अंजुम जी के साथ उनका साथ देने और ये बहुत ही अच्छा एक एफर्ट है जिसमें कि लोगों को मौका मिलता है कि वो अपनी कहानियाँ लिख सकें बता सकें और इंडस्ट्री को एक नए राइटर्स मिल सकते हैं सो इट्स अ वंडरफुल एफर्ट एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू सपोर्ट दिस एफर्ट
Recently, Kabir Khan had also said something like this, where he mentioned how there's a dearth of original scripts in the industry and how perhaps the industry didn't really nurture good writers.
Yeah.
Where did we go wrong in that sense?
Oh, I don't know. If you go back into history, I don't know. Actually, even traditionally, a lot of production houses used to have writers' rooms and they used to have writers on their payrolls at one time. I remember my uncle telling me that, you know, a lot of production houses used to have a number of writers writing for them. But somewhere down the line, I don't know where that kind of fizzled out.
I think money became more important than content,
the content.
As such. And people became, comfortable that these kind of films are doing well. So let's just, formula, what we call.
क्योंकि 50s और 60s में तो अलग अलग कहानियाँ बनती थी वो 70s में
90s तक आते आते कहीं थोड़ा सा
आउट से लेट 80s द चेंज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम QSQT
It is.
तो एक तो ये endeavor है to encourage people to come out and write. And we should not stop here. Industry में हमें writers को as producers, we should be paying them much more and sufficiently enough so that a person can lead a wonderful, comfortable life just on writing. कि लेखक होने के नाते मैं अच्छा कमाऊँ. और एक्चुअली हम जब फिल्म करते हैं, मैं क्यों फिल्म साइन करता हूँ? कहानी के बेसिस पे तो मैं फिल्म साइन करता हूँ जब स्क्रिप्ट अच्छी होती है. तो एक्चुअली राइटर इज़ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट आई फील एस्पेक्ट. वहाँ से तो हर चीज़ शुरू होती है. द ओरिजिन इज़ द राइटर. राइटर अच्छी कहानी लिखता है तो हम सब जुड़ते हैं उसमें. सो इन दैट सेंस द राइटर इज़ एक्चुअली फंडामेंटल पर्सन इन दिस होल प्रोसेस. नो डाउट इट इज़ अ डायरेक्टर्स मीडियम बिकॉज द डायरेक्टर बिकम्स द नरेटर ऑफ द स्टोरी. बट द राइटर इज़ द वन हु ओरिजिनेट्स इट. एंड येस इट्स टीम वर्क. उसमें एक्टर्स भी आते हैं, टेक्नीशियंस भी आते हैं, लेकिन ये सारी शुरुआत जो है लेखक से होती है. तो उसको एक स्पेशल ओहदा मिलना चाहिए मेरे हिसाब से. एंड द मॉनेटरी कॉम्पनसेशन फॉर अ राइटर शुड डेफिनेटली बी हायर इन द इंडस्ट्रीज व्हाट आई फील. एंड उस पर हम लोगों ने काफ़ी चर्चा भी की है अंजुम के साथ. एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट अ मॉडल ऑल्सो फॉर दैट.
राइटर को एक प्रॉपर अमाउंट मिलना चाहिए, उतना ही ऑर्डर मिलना चाहिए. रिसेंटली जो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस है उसमें राजू जी ने भी कहा कि ये सब और उसके अलावा रॉयल्टी भी मिलना चाहिए राइटर्स को. तो उसके ऊपर क्या कहना?
बिल्कुल. एक्चुअली वो हर डील पे थोड़ा फर्क हो सकता है उसमें. सम राइटर्स मे वॉन्ट टू चार्ज अ हायर अमाउंट अप फ्रंट. सम चार्जर्स मे राइटर्स मे प्रिफर टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉफिट्स एंड बी अ पार्ट ऑफ रॉयल्टी. बट यकीनन अगर राइटर को रॉयल्टी चाहिए उसको 101% मिलनी चाहिए. समबडी विद एन इमेजिनेशन. कोई अलग कहानी, अलग सिनेरियो हमारे सामने आए, किरदार अच्छे लिखे गए हों, प्रेमाइस क्लियर हो, गोल क्लियर हो, और वो पूरी जर्नी जो है कहानी की वो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा एंटरटेनिंग, एंगेजिंग हो. दैट्स व्हाट वी लुक फॉर इन अ गुड स्क्रिप्ट आई गेस. प्लॉट पॉइंट्स. हाँ, एक्चुअली द ब्यूटीफुल थिंग अबाउट दिस कॉम्पिटिशन इज के इसमें जब राइटर जो भी जीतेंगे उनको कैश प्राइज मिलेगा, लेकिन वो जो उनका कॉपीराइट है उस कहानी पे वो ना सिनिस्तान का है, ना हमारा है, ना किसी का है. वो उसी के पास रहेगा और वो जिसको चाहे देना चाहे वो दे सकता है. सो दैट इज़ वन ऑफ द गुड थिंग्स आई थिंक अबाउट दिस कॉम्पिटिशन. तो राइटर को पूरी फ्रीडम है और आज़ादी है कि उसको प्राइस तो मिल गई है, लेकिन इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि उसकी कहानी अब किसी की हो गई है. कहानी उसी की है और वो जिसको चाहे दे सकता है. Always the script.
Always
the script. In the beginning, very, very beginning of my career, after QSQT released, I was looking at only the script. Then I learned that I have to look at the script, the director, and the producer. Because if these three things are not in place, even a good script can go haywire. A good script needs a good director, and a good director needs a good producer. Who provides the team with the resources that the film needs, otherwise it won't be made properly, and to give it a good release. So for me, very early in my career I learned that script, director and producer, these three things are of prime importance to me.
So your last release had all the things in place.
Yeah.
Good producer, good director.
Yeah.
The star was just the star cast.
Yeah, yeah.
Then, I mean, when you look at the performance,
yeah.
Where do you think it has?
Well, I would like to say that, I take full responsibility for Thugs not working with the audience. I think we went wrong, but I would like to take full responsibility for that. You can be sure that we tried our level best. Humne koshish puri ki. कोशिश में कोई भी कसर नहीं छोड़ी हमने. लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं हम गलत गए. कुछ लोग हैं जिनको फिल्म पसंद आई है और उनका हम शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहेंगे और हमें खुशी है कि कुछ लोगों को पसंद आई है, लेकिन वो बहुत माइनॉरिटी में. ज़्यादातर लोगों को फिल्म पसंद नहीं आई हमारी और इस बात का हमें एहसास है. तो यकीनन कहीं ना कहीं हम गलत गए और मैं उस बात की पूरी जिम्मेदारी लेता हूँ. और जो ऑडियंस इतने एक्सपेक्टेशन से आई है मेरी फिल्म देखने के लिए, मैं उनको आई वॉन्ट टू अपोलोजाइज टू देम ऑल्सो कि इस दफ़ा मैं उनको वो एंटरटेन नहीं कर पाया. कोशिश हमने पूरी की थी लेकिन जो लोग इतने एक्सपेक्टेशन से आए उनको मज़ा नहीं आया. तो आई एम फीलिंग वेरी बैड दैट वी वर नॉट एबल टू एंटरटेन देम. एक्चुअली मैं अगली फिल्म क्या कर रहा हूँ वो मैंने अभी डिसाइड नहीं किया है. जैसे ही मैं डिसाइड करूँगा मैं बताऊँगा आपको.
आमिर, जब भी फिल्म फ्लॉप होती है तो एक एक्टर के लिए बहुत आसान होता है उसे कोपअप करना. तो किस तरह से आपने कोपअप किया जो ठग सा फिल्म था जब
वही करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ. वही कोशिश करने की.
सॉरी, हाँ
यार, ये सारी चीज़ें मैं आई एम नॉट कम्फर्टेबल कि मैं पब्लिकली बोलूँ, क्योंकि मैं अपनी फिल्मों के बहुत नज़दीक होता हूँ और जैसे हमारे लिए बच्चा होता है ना, वैसे मेरी फिल्में होती हैं. तो वो नाकामयाब भी होना वो मेरे ही हैं, मेरे ही बच्चे हैं. Well, I think that an audience is free to, you know, say what they want to say about a film. They are free to say what they want to say about the film. What I can say is that we certainly tried our level best, and I'm feeling very bad that we didn't succeed in entertaining the audience. Next time we'll try harder.
Was that with Thugs you are concentrating on you're focusing on the Chinese market now?
The China release will be happening next month, so certainly. Let's hope and see what happens there.
I mean, what do you think? What went wrong? Like, people are saying narration was not nice.
Again, I won't want to discuss that publicly.
Amit ji, because बच्चों के ऊपर हम देखते हैं कि present time में फिल्में बहुत ही कम बन रही हैं.
जी.
आपने आपकी एक फिल्म ऐसी तारे जमीन पर लोगों ने बहुत ही appreciate की.
जी जी.
आज हमने एक picture देखी आप हैं आजाद.
हाँ, आज़ाद की बर्थडे थी और वो एक्चुअली एस्ट्रिक्स के बहुत बड़े फ़ैन हैं. तो हम लोग ने उनके कुछ दोस्त, आज़ाद के 8-10 दोस्त और उनके पेरेंट्स, हम लोग सब पंचगिनी गए थे. तो वो इट वाज एन ऑब्लिक्स एंड एस्ट्रिक्स पार्टी. तो मैं ऑफ कोर्स ऑब्लिक्स बना एंड आज़ाद वाज एस्ट्रिक्स. डिड यू सी द फोटो? एंड किरण वाज गेट अ फिक्स द ड्रूड. और वो बाकायदा पूरा वो मैजिक पोशन भी बनाया गया और लाइन में जैसे खड़े होते हैं और मुझे रिफ्यूज़ किया गया, नो यू कैन नॉट गेट मैजिक पोशन.
सो द फर्स्ट थिंग, बच्चों के ऊपर हम और भी फिल्में देखेंगे जैसे तारे जमीन पे देखे.
जी
जी. वर्ल्ड लेवल पर जिन्होंने भी देखा लोगों ने अप्रिशिएट.
जी,
आपकी तरफ से स्टोरी की बात
नहीं, यकीनन बच्चों, एक्चुअली बच्चों के लिए हमको और ज़्यादा फिल्में बनानी चाहिए. मुझे लगता है कि हमारी इंडस्ट्री में हम लोग कम फिल्में बनाते हैं बच्चों के लिए, लिहाजा बच्चे बहुत सारी फिल्में देखते हैं. बट आई विश वी मेड मोर फिल्म्स फॉर चिल्ड्रन. यू एब्सोल्युटली राइट, यू एब्सोल्युटली राइट.
वेयर डू यू फाइंड योर इंस्पिरेशन फॉर व्हेन राइटिंग अ स्टोरी?
हु इज आस्किंग मी? इंस्पिरेशन इज व्हाट मूव्स यू profoundly and which raises questions in your mind. So it's either comes from reality or it comes from imagination. Reality could mean that you've been through the experience, somebody told you about it, or there was a memory which kicked in. Imagination is of course when you keep asking yourself what if, etc. And that if that question really stays with you and refuses to leave you, then the whole script process is to pursue that question, is to try seeking answers emotionally. What is likely to happen, and that's how the story unfolds. I don't know how.
Yeah, no, Juhi. Pretty much that. Yeah. Pretty much that. Yeah.
Amit sir, आपने कुछ लिखा है जो बनाना चाह रहे हैं कभी? क्योंकि अभी तो वक्त नहीं मिलता होगा, लेकिन एक टाइम.
मैंने अपने करियर में थोड़ी बहुत लिखाई की है, कयामत से कयामत तक, जो जीता वही सिकंदर, हमें राई प्यार के. अकेले मैंने नहीं लिखा है, जैसे रॉबिन भट्ट जी के साथ मैंने हमें राई प्यार के में काम किया था, मंसूर नुजत और चचरान के साथ हमने जो जीता, और तो इस लेवल पे मैंने थोड़ा बहुत काम किया है, लेकिन अकेले मैंने कोई कहानी नहीं लिखी है. डर लगता है मुझे बहुत. राइटिंग इज अ वेरी लोनली जॉब.
इट इज.
आई डोंट नो हाउ यू विल डू इट. हो सकता है कभी मैं लिखूं, आई डोंट नो. बट थोड़ा बहुत मैं काम करता हूँ. गुलाम पे भी हमने काफ़ी बहुत काम किया था. आई मीन अंजुम की पहली फिल्म थी वो एज अ राइटर. बट आई हैव नॉट फुल्ली रिटन इट माई सेल्फ एनी स्क्रिप्ट, नॉट सो फार.
On what parameters do you judge a script?
For me, it is something that, you know, at the first thing I look for is that as an audience, because it's like, at that time, I'm an audience watching a film. So does it excite me? Does it engage me? Does it, you know, suck me in? Does it? So first I go only purely by my emotional response to the script. Once something excites me, then I start looking for the technical side of it. But that comes later. I just want to make sure, okay, does it have a clear premise? Can we improve on the clarity of the premise? Does it have a clear goal? Is the goal set early enough? Are the characters developed well? Are the subplots, you know, interesting? Are any of the subplots not being closed and wound up before the main plot is over? So these are the few technical things that I look at, but that comes much later. My firstly, it is my, you know, gut reaction to a script is what I go with.
आखिर एक सवाल है कि बहुत सारे actors इन दिनों अपनी biographies autobiographies ला रहे हैं. आपकी ज़िंदगी में बहुत उतार चढ़ाव रहे हैं. As an actor बहुत struggle रहा है. हालांकि आपने ज़्यादा पढ़ाई नहीं किया उस दौरान के बारे में आपने काफी बात की है. तो कभी ऐसा होगा कि आप अपनी memoir लिखें ऐसा कुछ?
हाँ, मैं मुझे कई लोगों ने कहा भी है लिखने के लिए और कभी कभी मुझे लगता है हाँ कि लिखना चाहिए, लेकिन मुझे फिर थोड़ा घबराहट होती है क्योंकि मैं जब लिखूंगा और जो मैं बोलूंगा वो मैं सब सच सच बोल देता हूँ. लोगों को वो पसंद नहीं आता तो फिर मैं सोचता हूँ कि यार रहने दो यार.
क्यों आपको ऐसा लगता है कि बहुत लोग जब ऑटोबायोग्राफी लिखते हैं तो उसमें सब कुछ सच नहीं होता?
नहीं, वो तो क्या, वो ऑटोबायोग्राफी में आप जब, मतलब मैं अपनी बात करूँगा, मैं चाहूँगा कि मैं सब चीज़ें साफ साफ लिखूँ और कहूँ, लेकिन फिर कुछ चीज़ें आप नहीं बोल सकते उसमें, तो फिर वो एक स्ट्रगल होता है कि मैं फिर किस हद तक जाके मैं सच्चाई बोल सकता हूँ, किस हद तक मैं साफ साफ बोल सकता हूँ. लोगों के जज्बात इसमें इन्वॉल्व हैं, तो वो सब चीज़ें जब मैं सोचता हूँ, फिर मैं सोचता हूँ कि यार मन में ही रहने दो अपनी बात. You know, what you have to realize about biographies is that no one person in this world is viewed in exactly the same by the people around him. अगर आप मेरे पे कहानी लिखेंगे आपका एक नज़रिया होगा, आप लिखेंगे आपका नज़रिया दूसरा होगा, आप लिखेंगे आपका तो तीसरा बहुत ही अलग नज़रिया होगा. So you have to give the person who's writing it and making it, you have to give him that much respect and regard कि यार ये मेरा नज़रिया है. आप उससे agree करो नहीं करो वो अलग बात है, but I see you in this manner and that is how I can tell the story about you, about any character. So I would not call that whitewashing, or in the case of, suppose I feel that you're not a very nice person and I show you in bad light, that is the way I'm seeing you.
But you would agree there should be a distance from the source about whom you are writing or making the film?
No, there are no such rules.
No,
there are no rules.
Objectivity.
But everything is influence. How will you remove influence from it?
But I mean, objectivity would matter nahi karti. Objectivity.
Even if it's your own view, but
no. But what is wrong with a subjective view? I'm asking.
Yeah,
suppose I'm making a subjective view. भैया मैं ऑब्जेक्टिव नहीं हो रहा हूँ, मैं इमोशनल हो रहा हूँ. मैं अपने बच्चे पे कहानी लिख रहा हूँ, मैं इमोशनल होकर लिखूंगा, मैं क्यों ऑब्जेक्टिव रहूँ मेरे बच्चे के बारे में? वो मैं कर रहा हूँ.
लास्ट क्वेश्चन.
यू अंडरस्टैंड? सो देर आर नो रूल्स. यू कैन बी ऑब्जेक्टिव, यू कैन बी सब्जेक्टिव. इट्स अप टू यू, इट्स अप टू द फिल्म मेकर. व्हेन यू मेक अ बायोग्राफी, यू विल डिसाइड हाउ यू वांट टू मेक इट. यू नो व्हाट आई मीन?
I mean, is it like a wonderful reunion for you and Anjum, because you almost came very close to do Salute, which didn't turn out, and I think it's written in the film.
Anjum and I go back a long way.
Right. For the latest project that you came very close. I think Shah Rukh recently said also that because you were so consumed with some other project that you couldn't really.
Yeah, I think it's a great script. Salute is a wonderful script, and I'm a huge fan of Rakesh, and it's a wonderful story. And I feel sad that I was not able to do it, and which is why actually I called up Shah Rukh and said it's a wonderful story and you should hear it, and I'm so happy that he's liked it and he's doing it. So you know, all my very best wishes for the project.
How excited are you? Going on the floor?
February is what I have been told, that it will be going on the floor. Yes, I have been very excited because like Amir, even I have been a big fan of Rakesh, and now he's a good friend also. And yeah, frankly speaking, I was very keen that Amir do it, and Amir at that moment liked it. We discussed it a lot. We had a lot of sort of hopes for it. But unfortunately, the larger sort of project of Mahabharata, which he was concerned about.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
This is about the story of a person. That person is different from whoever character they will conceive of. So no, that doesn't matter. I mean, that way there are 20 films on crime simultaneously, on dakus, on you know, different people. So that doesn't matter. No, I'm not worried at all.
Thank you so much.
Scriptwriters Lab for 3 years, followed by Mumbai Mantra Cinerise screenwriting initiatives, we knew that the talent was out there. Through this contest, we have attempted to give an opportunity to every aspiring Indian scriptwriter with a story in their heart waiting to be the second edition has already been announced, for which the applications are currently open. Not taking any more time, I would like to introduce the people behind this initiative and would like to invite on stage Rohit Khattar, Chairman, Sinistan Digital.
Thank you, Preet. First of all, thank you all of you for so patiently waiting. A lot of the production houses and studios have been here since 1 o'clock, listening to the pitches and then waiting for this function. We are very, very grateful. We are very grateful to our contestants, our winners who've traveled a long distance to be here. At very short notice. We got to know about the actual date just a couple of weeks ago. So thank you very much. As she mentioned, we've had quite a journey. And in this journey, my partner in crime has been Anjum Rajavali. Anjum and I went to spend some time with Mr. Robert Redford at Park City in Sundance to see how screenwriting labs are actually curated and put together. It was quite an eye-opener for us. For the first 3 years, we brought in some of the greatest writers and directors from all across the world, and we were mentoring screenplays over 5 days. Then we thought we weren't reaching out enough, so we went across the country. Anjum did a lot of workshops trying to unearth talent. We realized the stories were there, but possibly the craft needed some honing. And even in this endeavor, we've realized that the great ideas and the craft needs to be developed, and that's something which we'll keep on expanding upon because the jury's been very, very generous and they've given us more time for next year. And I'd like to, in fact, one of the great desires that Sinistan has is to somehow get into the interiors of India. We have a remarkable gentleman here, Dinesh Ji, who's got 40,000 stores all across the country in tier 4, tier 5 towns of India. It's the second largest chain after Subway sandwiches. And you know, we don't really celebrate the fact that he's actually managed to go to everybody's doors. And through that, we're actually taking this talent for not only screenwriting, but many other talent contests that we're about to announce, which we'll take to the rural masses. We'll also be able to actually begin exhibitions in some way and show films. But that's for another time. Right now, I'd like to just thank our jury members. Raju Hirani, unfortunately, this date, as I said, was very last minute-ish, and he was already had planned to be overseas. I can't thank Juhi for being there for us. Amir, this is a very, very tense and difficult time. He's been traveling quite a bit, but they've given us their time so generously. And it's not just the 5 final winners. It was about 8 screenplays that came in, and I'm going to let Anjum talk a little bit about this, and he will explain to you what the process was. So without any further ado, I'd like to introduce the man who's literally the godfather of screenwriting in India. This is what he does. Other than he told me that I shouldn't say other than playing Kareena Kapoor's father recently in a film, I had no idea that he was also an actor. But Anjum, thank you so much again for being with us right from the beginning. May I please ask Anjum Rajabali, who's professor at FTII and at Whistling Woods in screenwriting, and our jury chairperson, to take over from me. Thank you. Come.
Thank you, Rohit. Good evening, all of you. It's really a pleasure and an honor to have all of you people here with us. Let me cut to the chase. It's an oft-repeated observation and a complaint that screenwriting has been a neglected craft of the film industry. But merely because it's been repeated so often doesn't make it invalid or untrue. We have suffered, our cinema has suffered on account of that, that the basic force which goes into the making of an engaging, impactful film, which is the script, if that itself we are foggy about, if that itself we are willing to dismiss, and if that itself we are not willing to hold as the central determinant of a good film, and are going to try and sort of rely on the props, on big stars, on great production values, on good looks, on costumes, on wonderful music, but if the screenplay doesn't work, none of this will work. So it is important for us to repeatedly take cognizance of this lack that historically we seem to have actually indulged in. Now this is where somebody like Sinestan and Rohit Khattar actually come in, because this conversation began with Rohit many years ago, more than a decade ago, that what is it, why is it that we are not able to compete internationally? Why is it that our cinema is not taken seriously on global platforms? Why is it that we don't get, you know, Cannes winners and, you know, Berlin winners and Venice winners and why, or Oscar, for example, you know? And of course, the whole analysis came up with only one answer, that it is important for us to develop our screenwriting talent in this country. Now, it's said that there aren't enough scriptwriters in this country. Well, it's true and not true. There aren't enough professionally developed screenwriters in this country, yes, but there is enough screenwriting talent available in this country. It is raw. It needs some hand-holding. It needs for them to develop their craft. It needs for them to learn a professional polish on that. And it is that lack, that putting in this guidance, putting in mentors, putting in this advice, doing a bit of hand-holding and encouraging people, to talented people, to take to screenwriting. This led to a series of initiatives that Rohit and I, in a way, sort of began. There was a script lab with Sundance, which is the most prestigious lab in the world. 3 years running, we held that, then we held our lab on our own, and of course did several workshops, series of masterclasses across the country, and yet we felt that we still need to take a step further. A lot of discussions took place at the Screenwriters Association, in fact, because we are engaged with the same problem, that we need to do something else, keep doing something more, to make sure that there is a certain booster shot to be given to aspiring, the community of aspiring screenwriters, to attract them towards it, to help them to develop it. And there came the simplest of ideas. Why don't we have a contest? Why don't we give some spectacular rewards? And it's, I mean, I cannot thank Mr. Rohit Khattar enough. I know he feels embarrassed for me to even say this publicly, but we do have to acknowledge, I mean, the entire screenwriting community and the community of aspiring writers owes a debt of gratitude to Mr. Rohit Khattar and his team and his company for having agreed to this. I mean, it bears repetition that 50 lakh worth of prizes given away with no strings attached, There is no lien on anybody's copyright. There is no conditionality at all which is imposed on the participants. It is merely that if you write well, we will reward you with wonderful prizes. 25 lakh as the first prize. I mean, I haven't come across anywhere in the world any contest which just gives this away. Okay? And he agreed to do that. So, anyway, so this led to a very onerous task that, yes, we had to announce, we had to publicize, we had to encourage writers from all over the country to participate in this, no matter whether they were sort of involved in some other profession, whether they were non-professional, whether they were merely housewives, workers. I mean, there were several people who merely were, I mean, they were driving cars, they were chauffeurs. All these people applied because they had stories to tell. I mean, India is the land of storytelling. And we had, as Sukhpreet said, 3,642 stories which were submitted. It was a huge task to go through them. All of us admit upfront, and I am the first person to state it here, that there is always a subjective element when it comes to judging stories. All our top nominees who are sitting here, you should know that. That those people who have not necessarily been able to reach this stage, it's not any significant or a serious comment on their efforts. It just so happened, okay, that somewhere or the other there was a certain lag, somewhere perhaps collectively the jury felt maybe not, maybe this. It's beyond a point. There is the X factor which is involved. Okay, we're very happy that you people are here, undoubtedly, and you deserve to be here. But that's not to convey any discouragement to those people who did not make it here, is what I'm trying to say. Even within you, when we announce the prizes, it's likely that some of you may feel disappointed, I ought to have perhaps been up there. Or it doesn't matter. The fact is that you are here. It's a wonderful achievement in any case. So we had this onerous task of reading, and there were systems built in which were so arduous that we are still exhausted. I mean, it's been a year of this whole thing, and I'm completely exhausted. So stories, after that, 156 stories were selected, and we asked them to send us their screenplays. 126 people sent in their screenplays, which were read, reread, cross-read, cross-discussed, cross-checked several times to ensure that some modicum of objectivity at least was attempted to judge them, and there should be complete neutrality. So there was nobody knew whose names they were. The jury came to know the names of you people today, now, in the evening. That's when I revealed it to them. Nobody knew this at all. Okay, I didn't know it. No one knew this. Okay, so we tried to maintain that objectivity. And of course, 20 were selected. A team of two senior writers and myself went through those 20, came up with 8. Again, after cross-checking, and each one read the full number of scripts. And then 8 scripts were sent to Juhi, Amir, Raju, and I reread them. And finally, we have come to this decision of 5. We will see where it goes right now. Okay, you're holding your breath as you should be, because this is a sensational achievement. Okay. So before I call upon Amir onto the stage, Rohit, one sort of unconditional and one deeply heartfelt, okay, word of thanks to you. And the fact is, there was a line in Sholay, which I have repeated earlier, and I will say it now. When the Thakur tells Veeru and Jay, after he's got them beaten up by his friends and by his people, to test whether he was right in calling them here, and he says, "Maine koi galati to nahi ki tumko bula ke." And as he goes away, Veeru says, "Ek galati zarur ki Thakur, tijori khol ke dikha di." So here I am not. I'm not referring to your treasury or your finance. I'm referring to aapke dil ki tijori aapne khol ke dikha di. And you can be sure, I'm a screenwriter. We will exploit you. We will continue to do that. And I will say the same thing to the jury. Aapne bhi apne dil ki tijori khol ke dikha di humko. Ab hum aapko chhodenge nahi. Okay. I actually have to introduce Amir. I mean, all of you know who Amir is, but what I have to introduce about him is not merely his canniness or his astuteness at being able to pick scripts well, which he has done. I mean, he's known for that. I mean, his whole concentration is always on the script. And if the script doesn't work, no matter how big the director is, he never takes on that project. Okay, nothing else matters to him if the script doesn't work. And yet, I also have to tell you that he's been a writer. He's written several scripts, I mean, co-written, but he's contributed full drafts to Jojita Vahi Sikandar, Hum Hai Rahi Pyar Ke, with Robin, there was a third one. QSQT, of course. QSQT is what, so these are, I mean, and the point is that I worked with him on two films. One, unfortunately, didn't get made because he was doing something else, which is Salute, but in Gulam, I mean, I wrote 21 drafts, okay, and each one of those drafts, he was happy to discuss each one of them. And it was an arduous discussion, but the fact is that I also could not come away without sort of really the admiration, not just for his canniness, not just for his intelligence in the way in which he was able to analyze and respond to scripts, but also the tenacity with which, that conviction which he hung on to. And I realized that this is what makes an achiever. So I just wanted to sort of underline that it has actually been, I mean, Amir has been a person who has all along in his career been involved with screenwriting, and he's been one of our greatest supporters. Can't thank you enough, Amir. Please, again, deeply heartfelt sense of gratitude towards you, and I invite you to the stage, please. And I request you to please share your thoughts about the contest. A few words, please.
Hello, everyone. सबसे पहले तो ये बहुत ही उंदा कॉन्सेप्ट है ये कॉन्टेस्ट रखने का और सिनिस्तान ने जो किया है इससे एक मौका मिलता है देश भर में और देश के बाहर से भी लोगों को कि वो अपनी कहानियाँ भेजें जो उनके मन में है वो बोल पाएँ और उसके साथ साथ हमारी इंडस्ट्री के लिए ये बहुत ज़रूरी है कि हमें और ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा राइटर्स मिलें और ये जो कोशिश है टू डेवलप राइटर्स एंड गेट मोर एंड मोर पीपल इनटू इट एंड देन आल्सो यू नो होपफुली होन देयर क्राफ्ट is a wonderful attempt and I'm happy ke anjum aur rohit ye kar rahe hain aur mujhe badi khushi hai ki main iska ek hissa ho saka hu 100 se zyada scripts aapne kaha aapne padhi maine to jo mujhe bheji gayi wohi padhi aur main ye kahunga ki in sari scripts mein mujhe ek bahut hi acha writer nazar aaya alag alag concepts hain कैरेक्टर्स बड़े अच्छे डेवलप किए हैं द क्राफ्ट इज़ प्रीटी वेल होन्ड एंड आई वाज क्वाइट हैप्पी एंड इम्प्रेस्ड टू रीड ऑल द स्क्रिप्ट्स इट वाज वेरी एंगेजिंग इट वाज ग्रेट फन रीडिंग देम एंड आई एम समवन हु लव स्टोरीज मुझे कहानियाँ सुनने का बहुत मज़ा आता है मुझे तो मैं किताबें भी बहुत पढ़ता हूँ तो आप लोगों की कहानियाँ जो मैंने पढ़ी मुझे बहुत मज़ा आया थैंक यू सो मच इट वॉज वेरी एंटरटेनिंग एंड I'm just glad to be a part of this process and hopefully this will result in, you know, our level of writing improving and it's something that certainly we need to pay more attention to and I think jo hum log value dete hain writing ko wo har tarike se dena hame na sirf hame writers ko zyada izzat deni chahiye lekin humko writers ko zyada paise bhi dene chahiye and I think that is something that is very important हाँ दिल की बात बोली फिर से न सिर्फ इज्जत लेकिन पैसे भी मिलने चाहिए राइटर्स को ठीक से और मैं आपको एक बात बता दूं हमारे जो मेरी प्रोडक्शन है किरण और मेरी आमिर खान प्रोडक्शन उसमें राइटर का नाम जो है ना वो सेकंड आता है पहले जो आता है नाम वो डायरेक्टर का आता है और प्रोड्यूसर का नाम थर्ड आता है वी ऑलवेज पुट आवर नेम आफ्टर द राइटर एंड सर्टनली वी मेक श्योर दैट वी compensate the writer to the satisfaction of the writer and at times we have even paid them more than what they wanted so this is something that I would strongly recommend to producers that you must give the value to the writer ek kahani ki wajah se hi hum sab us film ke sath judte hain to us cheez ka hame pura ehsaas hona chahiye aur us cheez ko hame puri izzat deni chahiye thank you so much
uh Unfortunately, Raju's not with us because he's been traveling and we couldn't sort of manage to coincide the dates of all the jury members. So we had to take a call here. However, we do have our other jury member with us, I mean, who's clearly regarded today as one of the finest writers in Hindi popular cinema, who's given us 3 films of which she's written the story, screenplay, and dialogue on her own. And all 3 of them have been based on extremely unusual premises, with the worlds that she's created within each film being palpably real. And that seems to be her forte, that she's able to situate characters in worlds whereby there is an organic relationship between the two, and therefore the story seems to just flow out of what the characters feel in those circumstances, rather than it appearing in any way, even for a second, constructed. And that screenwriter, as you all know, who we have celebrated over the last few years, is Ms. Juhi Chaturvedi. I please invite her onto the stage. And Juhi, a few words.
Rohit and Sinistan, really grateful to make me a part of this process. Because while, yes, I have written films and they have sort of worked, they've connected with people, but as a writer or as a thinking person, you know, I just feel that when I was reading all the scripts, I felt I was evolving a lot more. You know, when you read your stuff, and you, when you read somebody else's stuff, and for not one minute, I felt that it had any gimmick or it was written to win an award. And another very important point I would like to make, that we all, I mean, I'm asked this question many times, that as a woman, what do you think, should there be more women writers in the industry to have more sensitive films or films which are more women-oriented and they understand those sentiments? But like Anjum said, that I got to know the names only today, and I was surprised that there was such brilliant writing, and each character, each female character in all the scripts was so beautifully etched out, and it wasn't a woman that was writing. There are 5 guys who are sitting over here, and it's amazing. So we don't need a woman writer or a man writer. We just need sensitive writers. We just need people who understand emotions. We need to understand men equally. We need to understand women beautifully. And it's only then beautiful films will come out, beautiful scripts will come out. And it's just really amazing how well you have written, all of you. I thank you for giving this kind of content. And I really hope that this reaches everyone. It should be made into film. I'm so happy.
Moving on to the main agenda of the evening, let us look at our 5 finalists who are already winners, having reached this stage of the competition. Earlier during the day, we've had studios and production houses meet these finalists for pitch sessions. We have our fingers crossed that all these stories reach the silver screen, and wish the 5 contestants all the best. And I request Anjum Rajabali to introduce the stories of our 5 finalist scriptwriters.
Thanks, Sukhpreet. This is a bit of a challenge because I have also grown very close to your stories to be able to extract just a few lines. Also, I don't want to give away much of the specifics and the uniqueness of that. So forgive me if I am a little clumsy in my formulation of your central premises. See, one of the media persons did ask us, what is it that you were actually looking for? Many things, but primarily originality. As the Raghavan brothers sitting there will affirm repeatedly, that that has been the challenge of the Indian film industry, to develop confidence, not just for writers in themselves, but also for producers and directors, to develop confidence in the original voice of the writers and to trust that. One doesn't have to necessarily be driven by precedent, because it has worked earlier, then we should do something similar because then it'll work. Because that is not storytelling. I mean, that is like, you know, following some, you know, there's a precedent-driven industry, unfortunately, which is what we seem to have become in a large part. This whole contest also has been an attempt to break that down. I can say with full confidence that these 5 are original voices. They have an original style. They have not Actually, you don't find a resonance of anything which I have read or seen in their work. Let me take it up one by one as they are sitting there in that order. The first person sitting there, and if you can also get up and just greet the crowd, that will be nice, is Biplab Goswami, who has come from Kolkata. Biplab's script is called Two Brides, and it has a fantastic hook, which all of us read it and instantly fell in love with, which is about two brides getting exchanged. And all hell breaks loose after that. And the thing is that he has written it in a way where the texture of the milieu that he has created, at the same time, the kind of individuality of these two women and their two individual husbands and their families is so distinctive that you feel as if you know them. I mean, we haven't had enough time to interview him to find out exactly where he got his material from. But the opening scene is a scene described in a crowded train. It's a really a crowded train, you know, which is where the mix-up takes place. You could actually feel that. You could feel the sweaty smell. You could feel the sort of, you know, atmosphere, which was all very oppressive and people waiting to just get off. Beautifully created. And this is what we're beginning to find. And Biplab's not a professionally trained writer at all. I mean, none of them are trained writers. And yet there seems to be this talent in them to be able to express themselves with such an experiential approach to writing. So that's what Biplab's story is about. Next to him, the person who's sitting is Rajdeep. Rajdeep, Rajdeep is a journalist from Guwahati. Okay, and aap kabhi Bombay nahi aaye ho. He's never come to Bombay. I mean, like, how wonderful is that? I mean, how many of us are so lucky to have never come to Bombay? Sure. So Rajdeep's story also is wonderful. It's called Ishkology. And the whole premise is based on the conflict between science and truth. Where his position is that the character says that science is based on evidence, is based on something which has already been proven, whereas trust doesn't need proof. Okay, trust just needs a belief and a faith and perhaps love for the other person, where he believes that there can be no meaningful love without trust. So if he loves his wife, then he trusts his wife, and it doesn't matter about the proof of there's a whole mix-up about whose kid is it. So that's what the whole thing is about. And once again, very real. The whole texture is very experiential. So thank you very much for that pleasure that you gave us. And he says, what? Ishkology, something bigger than technology. I mean, I am imploring him to change the title, because Ishkology actually doesn't reflect the dignity, I'm sorry to say this, of the script. But think about it. Soch lo zara uske bare mein. The person sitting next to him is from Kochi. You're from Kochi? Yeah. That's Christo Tomi. It's crazy. Christo Tomi has written an entire script which is set in one location. Okay, and it's raining cats and dogs. It's the Kerala flood which is going on, and a person has died, and they just have to wait for the rain to stop so that they can get him buried, and the rain won't stop. And as a result of that stay, that claustrophobic sort of stay which takes place as a result of the rain, where everybody is paralyzed in that house, all kinds of relationships begin to unravel, and all kinds of questions and betrayals and deceits and breach of trust suddenly begins to happen, and the entire family, by the end of it, their whole nature of the network of relationships has changed completely. Their whole world has turned upside down merely because of the fact that they had to wait there before the rain to stop so that they could bury that damn corpse. Okay? So again, beautifully thought of. I mean, somewhere. And he says that actually he did have this experience, because in 2005 it was raining again, there were floods, and his grandfather had passed away, and for 5 days, you said, for 8 days they had to wait there locked up while the body was there, and there was a danger of the body decomposing. And he said, the way in which I saw the family going through this turbulence in their relationship, that is what seemed to have fascinated him and created a memory which led to this particular film. Next to him is our good friend Sagar Pandya. His story is completely different from the others in terms of its genre. It's a thriller. It's a thriller where the protagonist is a woman. Okay, and it's a revenge drama. It's written very competently. All of us were quite impressed with the style, and we knew that there must be somebody who's experienced. So Sagar may not be a hugely established writer, but he certainly, I mean, I happen to know, because I do know him, and I've known him since 2001, been writing damn near continuously. And he's really perfected his craft of writing. So it's written, it's crafted rather well. okay, and engaging and throbbing, very different from these other very personal, you know, small place stories, etc. So well done, Sagar. And of course, the last but not the least sitting on that side is Satyan Bordoloi, who's a documentary filmmaker and generally a man about town, let me put it that way. His story is titled, Sagar's story is titled Sniper. And Christo's title I didn't give you, it's called The Funeral. Satyan's story is titled Who Will Marry Thomas? And it's once again set in a remote forest where the only link between the forest and between the hamlet and the city is a bus. One lone bus, which is their lifeline. And when that lifeline gets threatened, relationships start falling apart. Marriages which are to be done suddenly don't happen because people feel, I don't want to marry my daughter into a place where there's no connectivity. Okay, so everybody is desperate. They almost worship that damn bus. And that bus is merely Hitchcock would call a MacGuffin, because the real story is about what happens to this village and what happens to this family. And there's a widow, and then there's a disappeared father who everyone's looking for. There is a man who's obsessed with the forest, who doesn't want a wife, and the mother going around trying to ask everybody, who will marry Thomas? Again, very done in a very lighthearted way, though it has a slightly serious undercurrent. But the treatment is very lighthearted. Once again, as Juhi pointed out, in all these stories, there are strong women characters, well-defined women characters, with their femininity uncompromisingly intact and distinctive. So kudos to that. That's another feather in your caps. Thank you very much. That's a matter of great hope for us.
Thank you, Anju. Now the question which every aspiring scriptwriter wants to know the answer to. Why these five? What sets them apart from thousands of others?
Yeah, but you know, Sukhpreet was trying to tell us the nation wants to know, why are these so special? Yeah, more or less sort of we have actually discussed that, but in case you people would like to make a comment on what is it that you found really distinctive, and even in a general way, perhaps?
I think, let me start with Sniper. I found the opening of the film and the hook of the film very, very strong. Mm-hmm. Something very, very engaging. I'll just say a few lines because I don't want to give too much out about each film, also each script also. So on Sniper, what I really felt was the opening of the film was something that really immediately grabbed me. And it was written in a very racy and PC kind of a style. Who will marry Thomas is such an unusual idea, and it's such a fascinating idea. It was a, you know, journey that really took me into that world, and I just loved it. The funeral again was something that was written in a way which very unusual story, but you come to know the characters so closely, and the way the atmosphere is created about, you know, the rain falling and the floods is really, you know, something that you can almost feel, you can touch. Again, the character is very well written. And the lead character of the girl is wonderfully written. Ishkology, again, a great thought of, you know, is science or technology more accurate than what your heart says and what you trust? With a lot of humor and, you know, wonderfully written. And Two Brides, just when that two wives get, brides get changed, I was like, whoa, now what's going to happen? You know, I was really excited when I was reading that. And I loved the way it was also developed. And the character of that girl is so well written. In fact, all the characters, I think that, so it's, you know, all the five films are unique, very different from each other also. And all of them have got a certain heart in it, which is so wonderful to see.
You know, also, like what you said, that each and every film is definitely very, very distinct, unique, each script. But what also happened while I was reading them and after finishing each script, there was a smile on my face because there's this writer, Script is one part, but what is actually the script? Script is a writer's mind, his soul, his thought, his philosophy, his sum total of his experiences. And I was really eager to meet these people who had written these stories, because there are these five people over here who are trying their best to retain some amount of righteousness through their writing. You know, it's their mind. I really respect all of them, because whether it's the revenge story, whether it's the two brides, whether it's Sniper Funeral, or Who Will Marry Thomas, there's such Aurish Kalogi. They have tried their best to retain the... I'm not saying that all the films need to be very right and correct and morally sound. No, the characters are very quirky. All of them have shades of gray and all. But in the end, the purpose of film, not just film, the purpose of cinema, why do we make films? One is, you know, your normal feature film, normal regular film, and one is cinema. I think all of them go to that stage. The purpose of cinema is much bigger than entertainment. And I thought that was coming out beautifully in their scripts. It wasn't just to entertain. It's saying a very, very big point. All these films in very, you know, they're set in villages, they're set in small towns. And you know that our country has these people, has these characters. They didn't look like characters who've just brought in from somewhere else. So I felt very good after reading all these films. And I was eager to meet you because it's your mind and I'm really fascinated by it, really.
I have sort of said more or less from there what I felt. I can only emphasize one thing, that there's an honesty, that you people approached it without thinking, okay, this may impress so-and-so, or yeah, this particular actor might want to do it, or these things these days are running, that is the trend, so let me try and fit into that trend.
Dhanda kitna karegi?
Huh?
Dhanda kitna karegi?
Dhanda kitna karegi? None of these thoughts sort of came in, which is why there is this freshness to it. Each one looks very, very individualistically written, that it's come from a unique mind, and which is what every writer has, I mean, his or her own unique mind. Okay? And it's really a bit of a shame that, Atika, we don't have women there, but couldn't help it. I mean, we just sort of chose these. No, I would have liked it very much, because one of the things that we were also looking out for is to encourage more women to also enter screenwriting. I mean, it being such a wonderful field, as you know. It just so turned out. I mean, in
the... Next year.
Yeah, next year we're hoping that will happen. But next year, once again, we'll be blindfolded. So we don't pick, and we will not allow ourselves to pick, okay, because she's a woman, please give her that space. No, that kind of, obviously, tokenism no one is doing. But anyway, we're hoping that this will open out. We'll also do a demographic of to see how many women have applied. I'm sure now, by now, we have that statistic. That should be encouraging, and I think we should also declare that. Okay, and also a regional breakup. It will be nice to see from where all people have been coming. So, shall we now move to the final climax of this? Okay. Yeah, you give it to them. Great. I'll tell you who to. Okay. Here comes the big one. This is the announcement and of the winners and the awarding of the prize money and the certificates to you people by our esteemed jury sitting here, half of it. So, I'm going to start from bottom upwards, go in ascending order. So the fifth prize amongst the five of you, okay, is for a story which is very hard-hitting, which is led by a woman, and which is a throbbing thriller. So the story's title is Sniper, and the writer who takes this award is Mr. Sagar Pandya. Juhi, fourth prize goes to a story which I believe came conceptually into the mind of its author, and he looked at it like a tussle, a conflict between science and truth. And he turned it into a beautiful personal experience. And we just keep forgetting about that this, the starting point could have been that it really becomes a very emotional conflict, which has been treated with the right dose of humor and poignance. So the name of the story, as you might have guessed, is Ishqology, and the author is Rajdweep. Please. Amir, Amir. Third prize goes to a rather quirky a story based on a rather quirky idea written by a traveler who goes all over India and therefore has visited the most unlikely places, including forest areas and tribal hamlets, and who tries to empathize with them to figure out what is it that makes them tick and what is it that makes them so vulnerable. And he discovers that there is actually just a single bus which makes them depend on that. And when the bus is under threat, their lives become vulnerable. And that title of that story is Who Will Marry Thomas? And the author is Satyan Bordoloi. Right, so now we come to the final two, Biplav and Christo. Actually, let's not announce this at all. Okay, we'll close it here now, you'll be in suspense. Don't perspire. Okay, so the second prize goes to, once again, a story based on a very unusual concept, something which made Amir leap out of his bed when he was reading it that night. It's about how in a crowded train, a rather unfortunate mix-up takes place, and two brides get exchanged, and then the series of events which sort of flow out of that, causing humor as well as pathos, deeply emotionally written. And the title of the story is Two Brides, and the author is Biplab Goswami. Now I wonder who the top prize goes to. Who could it be, possibly? I also have to reveal confidential matter here, that seldom when a jury of four is judging stories, scripts based on stories, seldom are the decisions unanimous. Okay, because there is, I told you, a subjective element. Certain things appeal to me in a particular way and might sort of appeal to somebody else differently. So there was a lot of confabulation. There was a lot of debate. There weren't that many differences at all. But yeah, a couple of places we did have to discuss again and again and rediscuss. And I had to reread also to try and also again enter the discussion in a more substantial way. So hence, you do have to realize that it's a consensus that we have arrived at. To use Rajdweep's word, it was a scientific consensus, okay? Therefore, perhaps truthful. So the top award of the cash prize of 25 lakh goes to Christo Tomi for the